所以大乘经上常讲啊，十方三世佛共同一法身，啊，这就是肯定了啊，宇宙一切众生呢，跟我们自己的关系啊，是一个生命共同体，慈悲心、爱心呢，从这个地方生出来，啊，所以你自自然然你会爱护一切众生，啊，遇到众生有苦难，你一定会援手，啊，像这个观世音菩萨。那个千手千眼是表法的，这个意思就是我看到了，我一定呢就帮助到，啊，我听到了，我一定就援助到，啊，全心全力舍己为人，啊，把儒家这个人与人的关系、人与物的关系加深，啊，有了透彻理论的依据，啊，所以人。不是为自己活着的，是为整个宇宙整体而活着，啊，所以我们这个常常跟同学们在一块说了，说爱心遍宇宙，善意满人间，啊，你说这种心胸多么快乐。
So, in ancient China, the Confucianists and Taoists did not have a profound description about the universe. And when Buddhism was introduced to China, the Buddhism contributed greatly to the scholarly and intellectual property in China. And because Buddhism has a profound and thorough description of all the relationships in our universe, and as it described,The universe is just a common body is a one common body. So in other words, as Buddhist, one of the scriptures in Buddhism said, all Buddhas share the same body. And when you truly understand this relationship, then compassion and love will naturally arise from your heart. And you will naturally want to protect others, and when you see others suffering, you will naturally give your hands to help out. So there is a bodhisattva image in Buddhism, that is the Guanyin Bodhisattva with 1,000 arms and 1,000 hands. So this image signifies that whenever we see someone that needs help, we will offer our hands. So.When you truly understand it, you will do your best to help others, and you can sacrifice yourself. And the spirit of Buddhism says that love permeates the entire universe, and the kindness spread all around the world.
所以这个教育，啊，圣贤的教育，就是把宇宙。万物真相给我们说清楚说明白，啊，肯定人有过去有未来，啊，那么许多宗教也都能够肯定的，那人既然有过去有未来，那就绝对不是这样短暂的这个生命，啊，我们应该怎样为未来着想，生有生灭，灵性不生不灭了。所以真正明白这个道理，知道事实真相啊，那人生的意义价值是什么？是把自己的灵性不断向上提升，这就对了。啊，不断的什么呢？帮助一切众生，帮助别人就是帮助自己啊，伤害别人就是伤害自己啊。这个道理也不算很深的，啊，只要头稍微冷静冷静啊，你都能够体会得到，都能够想得到，啊，所以利人才是利己，损人决定损己，所以人家常说损人利己，这个话是错误的，损人决定不利己，利人才是利己。为什么不多做帮助别人的事情呢？ 帮助别人里头最重要的，帮助他觉悟，啊，帮助他回头，啊，所以现在这个世界上啊，有许多人是恐怖分子，恐怖从哪来的？是你自己制造的，啊，恐怖分子也是人呐，他的本性也是善良的，他也有佛性啊，啊，他为什么会变成这样的？你要去寻找他的原因。所以现在我常常在这个国际会议上听到是防恐，啊，哎，这个不能解决问题。你防他，他防你，永远在对立，永远不能够化解，啊，只有是越来越麻烦，越来越恐怖，啊，这个怎么样能化解呢？要在教学上，要真正的时候帮助他觉悟。帮助他明了，啊，这个人际的关系，啊，人与自然环境的关系，人与天地鬼神的关系，他真搞清楚，真搞明白了，这个怨恨呢就化解了，啊，所以中国，你看从医学上讲也是如此，西医讲消毒，消是消灭，那个心很厉害啊，那中国不讲消毒，中国讲解毒，化解。你看那心跟语气都是柔和的，啊，都不是那么样刚强的，啊，所以这刚强啊，不能解决问题，啊，一定要用柔和的方法。
So, the education of faith is all about the true relationship of the universe, and we have to acknowledge that all human beings have their past.Their covenant and their future, and as acknowledged by all many other religions as well. So, if we understand that we have the future, we have the past, then we will have to think of the consequence of our covenant actions. So, what is the true meaning of our life? That is to labor or to heighten our own spirit.Continuously, to help others continuously. So we have realized that to help others is equivalent to helping ourselves. To hurt others, it amounts to hurting yourself. Okay, so how can we help others? Well, the most important thing to help others is to help them get awakened.And understand the true relationships between the human beings. So when I was attending conferences all around the world, I was often hearing the term called terrorism prevention. So if you want to prevent terrorism, then perhaps you will never resolve the problem. So who created the terrorism? We have to understand that it is ourselves that created the terrorism.Because everybody has the good nature, the innate good nature. And if you are trying to eliminate or trying to fight terrorism, then conflicts will never be resolved. And you will only create more troubles. So, in other words, in order to help them, so the terrorists, we should first awaken them.About the true relationships between beings, then their hatred and or their terrorism could be resolved.
所以化解冲突一定要靠智慧，不能用感情，啊，决定不可以用贪嗔痴，贪嗔痴是决定不能解决问题的，啊，要用智慧。啊，要用真诚，要用诚意啊，从内心里面做功夫啊。这个我们也常常在讲习里面啊，给同学们共同勉励啊，把自己内心啊，从自己内心对一切人、对一切事、对一切物对立的念头要化解掉啊，决定不能够对立。别人对我对立可以，他没有觉悟啊，他在迷啊， 我如果已经觉悟了，我怎么能够跟他对立？啊，冲突一定是两方面他才能冲突，啊，我这边化解了，他这一方面虽然没有化解，他打到我这两个打空了，没有力量，啊，能化解问题，啊，所以对一切人事物啊，这个对立的念头不能有，矛盾的念头不能有，啊，冲突的念头不能有，让自己首先养成心平气和。心气平和，人生智慧，啊，智慧自然能够解决问题，智慧自然能够触类旁通，啊，我学的东西我可以旁通，我没有学到东西也能旁通。
So conflict or solution must be lying on the reason, not the emotion, not the greed or hatred or delusion.So this, the effective resolution has to arise from sincerity. So therefore, I was always reminding our students in my lecture that in order to resolve conflicts between you and others, we must start to eliminate conflicts and confrontations within our mind. So if others have a conflict,They want to fight with us. Well, that is because they are deluded. Okay, they are not awakened. But if I am awakened, I will not fight back. So when the fighting comes in, okay, it will automatically be dissolved. So therefore, we should always cultivate our kind and calm heart. Then the wisdom arises from the calm heart. And only wisdom.
那么我在日本冈山会议上啊，曾经给大众啊有个报告，里面特别强调了两句话，我们要看别人的好处，不要去记别人的恶念恶行，啊，这个对我们决定没有好处，啊，常常记别人的善意善行，我们的心永远是善的，啊，这个最愚笨的人啊，是把你自己的良心装一切众生的最不善的恶俗，你说这个人这是愚痴到基础啊，那我们有很好的心，为什么不装人家纯净纯善，人家不善的时候我们绝不放在心上，都把它丢掉，培养成自己的善心善意，啊，先度自己，然后你就能感化别人，就能够帮助别人。
When I was attending the International Peace Conference in Fukuyama, Japan, I told the participants that we should always look at others' goodness, not the bad.So we don't remember others' evil deeds or the evil behavior, and always remain at the kindness level. So only the stupid people would look at others' faults or others' bends, and then they change their mind into a chess hand. So therefore, I was teaching all my students that do not look at others' evil deeds, but also look at others'good behavior. And with this, then we can naturally remain at the kindness level.
我曾经说过，啊，别人都是对的，我是错的，别人错了也是对的，我对了也是错的，这个听的人就得摇头啊，这个很难做到，这里头有很深很深的哲理，啊，这是事实。你要真正能够切入这个境界，这就是入佛之见。
I have said in the past that others are always correct and I'm always wrong. Even when others are wrong.They are correct. and even I am correct, I am wrong. So this statement has a very profound basis of the Buddhism view. So if you can truly gain the insights from this statement, then you are set to have entered the Buddha.
如果我们都能够跟这个古圣先贤学习，跟佛菩萨学习，跟孔子学习，我们在这个世界会过到真正的幸福美满的生活。我们看这个世界是美好的这个机缘成熟这个机缘成熟就是多数人能够接受古圣先贤的教诲，这个世界灾难会化去，和平会落实我们有这个信心。
If every one of us can sincerely learn from the ancient saints and sages and sincerely learn from Confucius, and then we should be able to leadA happy life. So if the condition of truth, if the majority of the people can accept these teachings, then the conflicts will be effectively resolved and we can attain the long lasting peace.
教育一定要从本身做起学为人师，行为示范，我们起心动念，言语造作都要给社会做出最好的榜样所以每一个人都有责任有义务教导这个社会。
The education has to start from our own self. So we should learn to be the teachers of others and also behave as an exemplary as an example for the society. And every thought of us would have to be that good example for the people.
那么在这个一年多我走了很多地方也遇到不少的这些知识人人从国家领导人到各个宗教的领袖我们的理念几乎都被他们肯定都被他们欢迎所以就交了很多的好朋友，我们同心协力为世界和平认真的来做。
In the past more than 1 year when I was traveling all around the world and I met many people with compassion mind, and they including thoseof the high officials in various countries, and because they all understand and they all accept the notions that I put forward, so we all become good friends. And I'm hoping that I can work together with all these good people for the world peace.
最后我是非常的期望着我们这个和平中心呢将来把这个研究的一些成果一定要利用这个高科技的媒体向全世界播放因为伦理道德和平的教育是全民教育，是全人类的教育不是在学校里某几个研究生呢那个不能解决问题所以今天为什么社会上这些形象跟我们的理想相反，我们的教学范围圈子太小了一定用网际网络，用卫星电视同时让全世界的人我们一起来学习那个效果就会很大，而且传播得很快收效果也会很快速。
So finally, I sincerely hope that the Center for Peace and Conflict Studies could use the high technology like internet to broadcast to spread the results of all the economic programs that is going on, and we can spread all these results to all around the world, informing all the people in the world. So the education of peace is not just for university, it's not to just graduate several PhDs in a year, but it's actually the education for all the population in the entire world. So if we just limit our education in the classrooms, the effect will not be that great. So we should maximize the effect and the influence of our peace education programs.
那我自己使用这个网际网络七年了，利用这个卫星电视来教学来讲经也差不多将近两年了。我们没有广告，我们没有向外面捐款，都是听众自动寄点钱给我们的这个银行账户，我们的开销足够了。从这个地方肯定这个世间有很多好人，很多善人，很多人支持正面的所以用不着这个负面的报道的时候吸收广告再来做这些东西，那个观念错误了现在我们有事实证明了我们的信心呢更坚定了。
in my past 7 years, I have been utilizing the internet application for long distance education, and also I have used the satellite TV channel for education for 2 years, and I never advertised or have any promotion programs, but lots of the support, financial support, has been sent in. So as long as we can put up the bank account on the internet, then money automatically comes in. So this confirms that there are lots of good people with kind hearts that want to support this type of educational program. So if we truly work for the best interest of the world, then there's no need to do advertisement, and we shouldn't worry about financial support.
好，我的报告就到这里结束，谢谢大家。
Before that, however, I just want to kind of make an announcement that if any of you are worried about parking, I know we should be focusing on the mundane, if any of you are worried about parking vouchers will be available from Catherine Northway during the reception, which will mean you don't have to pay fines for parking place without them. So I just wanted to kind of draw some of the threads together and then see if we can throw it over for discussion. One of the things I think that all of the speakers focused on was the kind of the essential nature of truth, truth-telling and a rigorous aspiration for truth. And I think that's something which really is at the heart of integrity and honesty and sincerity and in a sense, lies at the heart of ethical behavior. And that's something I think which comes from very ancient times in which we've very much forgotten often. As people say, what's happened to wisdom has given way to knowledge, what's happened to knowledge has given way to information, and we've lost some of that rigorous concern for truth. Secondly, I think there's been a kind of a strong preoccupation in all of the speakers with the question of civility, the way in which we deal with each other, the way in which we connect with each other, and that goes to the heart of a very, very important both Buddhist, Christian, and Muslim injunction, which is to be your brother and sister's keeper in a way. Ignorance in Buddhist philosophy, as I understand it, has to do with an ignorance of the way in which we are connected to each other, our interdependence, And I think the Venerable Master has reminded us that there is a sort of a key component of not only a good education and a way to happiness and contentment, it's a key part of being a human being in a human community. And the third theme, which I think has come through loud and clear, has been a concern around compassion. What is the role of compassion, our ability to empathize with those who are different from ourselves? So it has to do with kind of tolerance and pluralism and openness and connectedness and a willingness to respond to everybody's need. And an acknowledgement that the diminishment of anybody anywhere diminishes all of us, and certainly in terms of kind of violence and conflict. The preventable death of anybody anywhere diminishes all of us. And I think that's another theme which has come through very clearly in all of the contributions. And then there have been some very important issues around just what does constitute a kind of a peaceful pedagogy itself. How do we teach in ways which are going to have not only an effect on attitudes, but more importantly, an effect on behavior. It's good to be reminded by the Venerable Master that there is a sense in which the best education is exemplary education. The best teachers teach by examples, by as much as what they say, or by the knowledge they impart. And that has to do with some kind of quality of living. So I don't want to talk anymore, but it seems to me that there are some of the themes which in a sense have come through this rather rich discussion, and now I want to throw it open to you for a conversation around these issues. We have half an hour at least, and then we can break for refreshments. So once again, on behalf of all of you, I'd like to thank all of our speakers, and then throw it over to you now for some conversation and discussion. There is also a roving microphone here if you want to use that. And if you want to speak in Chinese, Mao Zhen or Stephen will translate for you. So, would you like
this? Thank you, everyone. I'm an overseas student from China, and also I'm a Buddhism setter of. Respect the Master Qing Hong very much. I want to give my opinions about this, today's speech. I think education is very important for our world's peace and development. But I think education is not the only tool that maintains our order. There, education cannot exclude politics and militants. And I think in today's world, militant and politics is also very, very important for our world. We cannot say that education is very important, then we should not use the militant to counter terrorism. This is my one point, and I think terrorism is not an issue of religions, and I think terrorism, for example, if the terrorist Laden he wants Master Qing Hong to convert from Buddhism to Islamic, what will Master Qing Hong choose? My opinion is that terrorism issue is not a thing about religion, but about the violence. We must use politics and militants to eliminate this.
Thanks very much. Do you want to ask a question of the panel as well?
Yes. So I just want to give my opinion.
Okay, thanks very much. Did you get that translated? Yes, no, he just wanted to give his opinion. Are there other comments or questions or... Yes. Yes.
Good afternoon, everyone. Linda, Director Kevin, and some lecturer from Religion Department. My name is Tom, and I was the first Taiwanese student study religions in postgraduate degree in this university. And I was very happy and honored, and most delighted to be here tonight, today. I have a question for Jin Kong, Baron. While we're talking about the conference, conflict and also the terrorism, but it starts from being ourselves, and it will be divided in three sections. First is our physically, and then it's mentally and spiritually. And I would like to ask Reverend Jin Kong the difference between the mental and the spirit. 我是台湾的学生，我是当年的第一位台湾学生在这边念宗教研究所的硕士生，已经是六七年前，当时是一个创举，因为开校以来没有一个台湾学生要念宗教。我的问题是要问净空法师，他呢在这个整个演讲当中呢提到一个问题，就是说所有的这些灾难跟恐怖的这些行为呢，都是来自一个人的一个行为，那这人呢有分为身心灵，那我想请问这个净空法师，心跟灵的差异在哪边？
The difference between the mental and spiritual.
这个问题问得很广，也问得很深，不是几句话短时间能够解答的。这个要知道，你既然研究宗教，大学经验，我常常说的呀，宇宙众生是唯心所系，唯一识所有。这两句话就把它讲尽，可是这两句话要把它解释开呀。我们每天讲八个小时，一百年都讲不完，这是实实在在。我现在在讲华语，已经讲了2500多个小时，全经才讲十分之一。如果像这个进步再讲下去，至少要超过2万小时才把这部经不能讲透彻，讲个皮毛而已。你就想一个问题，就是不多话，但是佛祖所能讲的是四十种相，你完全了解明白了，你才知道。设法进入一真法门，重新讲三。那设什么心？妄想。所以你只要不起心、不动念、不分别、不执着，这个世界就没有。儒家大师讲的“梦里一迷有六趣，具有后空”。这不是这样，所有境界不是真实，现代科学也逐渐发现。这个中国是去年在这个太空总署记录下来这个报告，我看了之后很接近，但是没有佛法讲的那么透彻。他这个科学发现说明我们现在的现象不是真实，时间和空间都是假的。在某一种条件之下不消失，空间消失就是没有全部，时间消失就没有先后，这个宇宙的起源，它虽然讲这一点讲得不够清楚，不够透彻，这个是跟这个大乘教育所说的有很大很大的距离，了解事实真相才晓得，这个一切法 真体从心相信。啊，只要你有念头，他就会现出幻想。你没有这个念头，这幻想就没有。所以我为什么说这个话呢？我说的很深的。别人错也是对，我对了也是错。这两句话你也听懂了，你这个疑虑啊问题都没有，这两句话很深很深啊！你真正彻底了解的时候，这个就是佛知佛见，这个就是佛的境界。我们要很虚心，要很认真，很努力的学习啊！我对这个佛法，对这些宗教，我已经学了53年，才学了皮毛。啊，并不是很透彻，但是稍稍起步境界，法喜充满。啊，不但我们本宗的佛教，所以我刚才透过你一步精通，一切通，一法通，一切法通。啊，那其他的这个宗教界里面，我们接触过，一般一点障碍。啊，所以说是人心的。定后头才能知道，你心是乱，心浮气躁，你知道，你所看的，你所想的，那就是金刚经上讲，凡是有相，就是虚妄。啊，但是几个人承认自己是虚妄，不会承认。啊，他要承认的，必须真正这个回归到。
So, well, your question is indeed a profound question, and of course the answer cannot be limited to just a few sentences. The experience, our mental and spiritual experience, according to the Mahayana Buddhism, physical, mental, and spiritual experience, according to the Mahayana Buddhism, are all created by our mind. This is a very profound theory. And the creation of mind theory, if you want to lecture on this theory for 8 hours a day for 100 days, you still cannot elaborate details.So, for example, I'm lecturing on the Flower Dome Sutra now for 2,500 hours, but it's just one-tenth of the entire sutra. So I estimate that I need 20,000 hours in total to finish the lecture, but I have to acknowledge and confess that all my lectures are just the surface of the sutras. So this is the truth.The essential truth of universe. And according to Zen, great Zen master, he said that if you are in a dream, then you can see clearly all the creatures, all the creations of the universe. However, when you are awake, then all this universe phenomena elapse and disappear.So according to the recent descriptions of this universe in the NASA website, the time and the space are all unreal. And also there are some sayings about the origin, the genesis of the universe. And of course, all these scientific sayings, the findings, are similar to what Buddha said in the sutras, but they are not thorough.And if you thoroughly understand this truth, then you can come to understand my earlier saying, why I was saying that if others, even though others are wrong, they are correct. And even though I am correct, I'm still wrong. So this level of understanding is so-called understanding of the Buddha. So if you can actually get into this level,you will feel the great happiness, the great joy. So when you keep a very calm heart and get into concentration, a deep concentration level, then the true wisdom arises. And therefore, if you have too many afflictions, within your mind, too many thoughts in your mind, then you will not arise the wisdom, but only worries. So in some way, this level of understanding has to be attained when you get to the origin of our universe. 刚才你就把忘了大法，你问了一个心，问了一个理，心是体，理是作用。心是本体，理是作用。就是one more amendment to your question, the answer is that we mentioned a difference between the mental spiritual levels. The mental aspect, the spiritual aspect is called the is the core quantum, and the mental level is the function of this core.
Good. Other questions and comments? So, yes.
I can speak English. 我在昆士兰大学刚刚学完新闻，那我刚来的时候写了一些负面的新闻，就报道像小吃店卖过期食品卖一年多了还摆在那里卖啊，就有一点 trouble 那样子，然后有一点麻烦。后来我认识了钟博士，然后钟博士说新闻的宗旨要恶恶扬善，那我很快我理解了这个理念。我就想问一下校长，就说像我们昆士兰大学的新闻系现在还在崇尚说调查新闻是最好的新闻，调查新闻是最有利的新闻，它跟和平你们这边和平中心研究的特别是不是有冲突？谢谢。I have just finished studying journalism semester one this year, and I have written some stories about the expired goods selling in the Chinese shop and caused some troubles. But the professors here in Queensland, they encouraged the investigative journalism very much. But when I talk on these issues to Dr. Zhong about the Buddhism idea about the news values, they tell me we should suppress the evils and praise the goodness. And then my report seems to be wrong in their concept. So here, I know in the University of Queensland, you are studying the world peace. And at the same time, the professors and the lecturers at the UQ and Journalism School, they still teach us to do our best to investigate, to have investigations on the bad issues of society, where every student like competing for good news. Because I think the news value here has some conflict with the world peace concept. So I just want to ask the Chancellor, what's your opinion about the education here in UQ?
I should say, clarify one thing, I'm not the Chancellor, all the Vice-Chancellors. And we have extremely good and cordial relationships with the School of Journalism. And the best I can do is suggest that it's probably the yin and the yang of it all. We're looking for the good and the positive and the hopeful and the optimistic, and journalism is reminding us of the realities that we're grappling with. Yes. There's a mic coming through.
The School of Education is considering implementing a peace education, and I guess as I hear the words tolerance and peace, they're very nice sounding words, but it seems to me an effective peace education program encourages students not to tolerate injustice, not to tolerate situations where of poverty, not to tolerate issues to do with refugees. And we should be encouraging students how to engage in conflict in productive ways, which in many ways then encourages our kids and our teachers to engage in conflict with the system. How do we do that in productive ways? And that's open to anyone.
I personally believe that there is a place for analysis, and I mean, there is often a clash. And when you do your work in education or as an academic, you need to engage your critical thinking skills. Once you start the critique, then you focus on the negative often. You also want to move towards positive values because there is a problem. So it's what Professor Thomas was saying, it is that yin and yang going between places, but it's really the critical issue here is, I mean, there are spaces within journalism as well. And Johann Galtung, Professor Galtung, always talks about that we not only need war journalists, but also peace journalists that will report on peace and develop that area. So there are little pockets that some of those things can be done. But I think the key issue is that when we talk about the social justice, whether you raise certain issues that need to be corrected and then move a next step and justify violence, that is what different types of violence, whether it's psychological or it's physical, there are different ways of doing things. And that's what peace education is exploring in many ways. It's really modeling and it's trying to teach nonviolently. It's about a different type of pedagogy. But it's also about the exploration.
Can I just put in a shameless plug as well for the January summer course, which is going to be on peace media, which is a combination of the Australian Centre for Peace and Conflict Studies and the School of Journalism. And it's precisely on what Ivana was talking about, which is how do you report conflicts in ways which are likely to result in more stability and more peaceful outcomes than if it bleeds, it bleeds. Other, yes?
有位菩萨叫地藏王菩萨，但是我想问一下，你觉得他能成佛吗？如果他成不了佛，是不是很遗憾？I can't translate the English correctly, so I don't know how to translate it. That's fine.
His question for the Venerable Master was that, specifically in Buddhism, there was a bodhisattva called 地藏王菩萨。Which means the earth treasure, Bodhisattva. And his vows, he vowed in the eons past that if all the sufferings do not get enlightened, then he will not become the Buddha. So the question for Master is that will he be able to become a Buddha someday?
Yeah, good question.
So
you have forgot about that.
这个佛法里面所讲的这个佛菩萨都是一种教学的方式啊，所以佛教是教啊，它是一种教学的方式，是一个表法的啊。地藏地是八地啊，藏是宝藏。我们知道我们人生活在这个世界决定不能离开地面，我们生活所需决定不能地上所长的地底下所藏的啊，这个正是佛用这个来代表我们的心意啊，所以代表心意，我们心里面心意里有无量的智慧，有无量的才艺，无量的德能，无量的佛啊，就像大地一样，能够去开采地藏代表这个意思，你 教学的，就是受教学也认识他。那么他用什么方法开禅呢？就是孝亲尊师，所以《地藏经》在佛门称为孝经，它的内容就是孝亲尊师。孝亲尊师能够开他的心灵法藏，他懂这个意思。啊，那个地狱堕落是不成佛，这就是悲悯慈悲。你要有这种悲心，为一切苦难众生服务。他们没有得到好的生活，我也不愿意过好的生活。他是这个意思。所以说，佛法里面所有一切的艺术都是表法，都是教授。他是不同这个一般的宗教里面，他宗教的时候当时应该佛教里面，这个你一定要明了。啊，不能把这个佛教里的佛菩萨当作神明看待，那你是有搞错的。啊，佛教里面的佛代表我们的本性。为什么那么多佛呢？本性万里得万，一个人没法不了。菩萨代表我们的心，你有修德才能恢复本自之德，这个性德。啊，所以菩萨代表心。那么在中国大乘文化里，地藏菩萨代表孝亲尊师，观音菩萨代表大慈大悲，文殊菩萨代表智慧，普贤菩萨代表实行。这个孝亲尊师啊，慈悲智慧都要落实到生活当中，所以它是表法。啊，它不是神，就像我们学校里面说教学空一样，它是一个空一样，是这个意思。
Okay. So, in Buddhism, Buddhism is an education, not a superstitious religion. So, the Earth Treasury Bodhisattva actually signifies the fact that our heart, our nature, our mind is like the earth, which can produce lots of good things and treasure.So, in other words, all things are the creation of the mind. And therefore, we need to explore this treasure from the earth. And so, in other words, this Bodhisattva is not a god, is not a superpower, but it is a way of teaching us to explore our own earth treasure. So, how do we explore this earth treasure?Well, the key to this exploration is to practice the filial piety and to practice the respect for the parents and teachers. So this is the foundation of all the teachings. So in other words, the Bodhisattvas vow that if all sufferings in the universe do not end, then I vow not to be the Buddha. So this does not mean that, this means that we should cultivate a compassion like this. Whenever we see the sufferings, we shouldn't live happily ourselves. And we should always contribute and service others. So this is all about the artistic education. And other examples in Bodhisattva include like Guan Yin Bodhisattva, which means great compassion. So we shouldn't just worship these Bodhisattvas as gods, but we should learn the content from the teaching.
This conversation could go on for a very long time, but I'm mindful of the fact that it's now 5:00 and we had promised that we would break for a reception right now. And before I call on the Dean of Social Behavioral Sciences to issue a formal word of thanks, I just want to say that we've started up a kind of a conversation here which in a sense models what we understand by peaceful education. Each one of us brings very different perspectives. I'm a New Zealander, we have a South African postmodernist constructivist, we have a Yugoslavian peace educator grappling with the issues of how you make that, and we have a Buddhist teacher and master who has given us some insight into the kind of paradox and the value of questions. And so I think we've opened up a kind of a conversation which is to some extent a model of what we like to see realized in this kind of pedagogy, which is to create spaces for the articulation of difference and the pursuit of truth. In a spirit of compassion. So I think we've, just on behalf of all of you, I would just like to kind of acknowledge that from all of our speakers before asking Linda here to issue a formal vote of thanks.
Well, thank you everybody for coming today. I think this is the first of our dialogues that we have held through the Peace and Conflict Studies Center. We hope that this will be the first of many. We are trying in our faculty, despite the concerns about journalism that were expressed, to start to model and think about peace and how to educate for peace at the university, how to educate the teachers who will be teaching our children, and how to educate ourselves about peace, about understanding, and about cultural diversity and the capacity to understand different cultures and different perspectives. So I'd like to thank all three speakers today for their insights that they have given us. And on behalf of the University of Queensland, I'd like to thank, firstly, the Venerable Master Jin Kung, and thank you very much. Two speakers from the School of Education at the University of Queensland, Isibari Milicevic and Professor Chan Christie. There is one more person who has put in a lot of the work, well, there are two people really, who put in a lot of the work for pulling this dialogue together. I'd like to thank, obviously, our Protocol and Ceremonies branch, but also Ms. Catherine Otway, who has been the person behind the scenes for the last 2 weeks, pulling this together. So thank you very much. Thank you all for your attendance, for your questions, and we'd like to invite you to join us for refreshments in the next room.